When I see a party who cheered on violence, violence that killed five, maybe now six people, a second Capitol Police officer took their life in the aftermath of the attack this past week. When we are still losing people, when we don't know how many people are gonna develop PTSD after what happened, when we don't know how many people are still hospitalized. I mean, there are people who, sure, they may not have passed away, but they lost fingers, they lost eyes. And these people are just trying to tell us it's not a big deal. And they're trying to say, you're making too big a deal over it. Or my favorite, this past week, Ted Cruz and now representatives Chip Roy, and oh, by the way, some of the other representatives who actually encouraged people to threaten members of Congress or tweeted out the location of the speaker are now telling me to apologize for saying and speaking truth to what happened. These are the tactics of abusers, or rather, these are the
exactly, yeah. There's little as sickening as the idea that she's the one who's actually done something wrong. And also revealing at the same time that they understand that they can ask for people to apologize or to give a statement when it's not a member of their own party. If it's something about, you know, revealing the abuse that you've suffered, then you're the bad person. If it's denying the existence of mass shootings, well, you know, I don't really want to talk about that. But anyway, I do want to go to another sort of related video, and then we'll have a chance to comment. Here she is talking about the situation.
See this happen, how I feel and how I felt was not again. I'm not going to let this happen again. I'm not going to let it happen to me again. I'm not going to let it happen to the other people who've been victimized by this situation again. And I'm not going to let this happen to our country ever. I'm not going to let it happen.
And that should be the goal for everyone. And I don't know exactly what needs to be done to make sure that it doesn't happen again, but I know that just pretending it didn't happen and having no consequences for anyone who incited it or aided it, I don't think that's going to accomplish that. So we're going to try something. Viviana, what do you think?
I mean, I'm right with her. We cannot let this happen again. We have to get people on both sides of the aisle to admit and acknowledge how incredibly serious this was. And, you know, we're not seeing it even with how these, you know, insurgents are being, or treasonous. I don't even know what to call them anymore. The insurgents is almost too good of a name for these people. You know, they are, and I'm going to be doing a video about this soon, John, but I'm likening them to gang affiliations. And when you're here in Los Angeles, my dad's done a lot of work with gangs and he works as an expert witness from time to time. And let's say you're 14 years old and you jump into a car and your cousin is going to go do a drive-by, and you have no idea your cousin's going to do a drive-by. But you've been jumped into the gang, you got your little tattoo 2 weeks before, you're in the car, you're just there. They go, they do a drive-by, they shoot someone, they kill someone. That 14-year-old gets life for just being there. And you're going to tell me that these insurgents get to skate free and get to ask for trips to Mexico and organic food and all this all this bail? You know, money that's just easy to, they just come right out. No, we need this kind of thing. This is the trauma she's talking about. Holding those people accountable and holding our leaders like Cruz and Hawley accountable is how we stop this from happening again. And that's not happening right now. And that's what everybody, and including the Biden administration, they're trying to be real soft-shoed with this. They need to come on heavy. This is an assault on our own soil by our own people. There's nothing more serious than that.
They seem to be taking it seriously. I mean, look, Biden hasn't really gotten involved in much of this, which is frustrating. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.